everything that goes into getting to this point is enormous. We had FDA accept our IND. We've had our orphan designation. So we've worked behind the scenes to get to this point. This is a rare cancer and with lots of unmet need. And patients are refractory and relapsed, and they really are looking for a new treatment.
Prescient Therapeutics has kicked off its phase 2A clinical trial evaluating PTX100 for relapsed or refractory cutaneous T-cell lymphoma, or CTCL, and dosed its first patient. New CEO James McDonnell is here to tell all about this major milestone. James, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Jonathan. Yes, it's been a busy week this week with the first patient in. It's taken a lot of effort to get to this point with getting everything organized and sites up and running. So it's we had really good responses in our phase one, and now we're kicking off the CTCL phase 2A.
So, James, can you talk me through what the trial is actually measuring in terms of how it works and its safety component and what it means to have actually dosed this first patient now?
Yeah, it means a lot to dose a patient because everything that goes into getting to this point is enormous. We had FDA accept our IND. We've had our orphan designation. So we've worked behind the scenes to get to this point. This is a rare cancer and with lots of unmet need. And patients are refractory and relapsed, and they really are looking for a new treatment option. So starting the study means that we're looking at a phase 2A and a phase 2B. The phase 2A can go up to 40 patients, so but we'll have a look-see around the halfway mark and see how we're tracking.
And you're running it in multiple countries. How does this help move things forward?
Yeah, well, it's a rare disease, so sometimes it's better to spread the load, if you like. But also, our anticipation is that we will be registering in or commercializing in the US, in Europe, and around the world. So it's important to have a bit of a spread there. And there are key clinicians throughout the world that are very keen to get their hands on PTX100 and start the study.
And we've touched on this with the company before, but can you talk us through how PTX100 differs from current treatments for CTCL?
Yeah, so PTX100 is a first-in-class inhibitor of general transferase 1, which basically disrupts the RAS family pathway. So it has a different mode of action. It's had some really good response rates in phase 1B, but also it has a very favourable safety profile. A lot of the drugs at the moment, the treatments available, have a quite serious adverse event profile as well. And so you're adding to the fragility of the patient. Whereas with PTX, we see a favourable safety profile and some good response rates. So that's pretty exciting, and that's why we're progressing.
And you mentioned the orphan drug designation earlier. Can you talk us through why that's so important to the company?
I mean, orphan drug designation means that you end up with 7 years exclusivity once you launch. So it doesn't start ticking. It only starts when you have marketing authorization. And we've also received fast track designation from the FDA, and this will help us in our discussions as we progress phase 2A into phase 2B. And there's potential for a registrational approach, so slightly faster timelines and reduced costs to get to market.
And James, you've touched on some of the points here, but can you talk us through what's next now for the company?
We're really focused on PTX100 and this CTCL. We will also look at the other peripheral T-cell lymphoma, maybe in an investigator-led approach, just to strengthen our T-cell lymphoma presence. And we are first in class with our general transferase 1 inhibitor. So a RAS family disruptor, and RAS is involved in 22% of cancers, and some more than others. And so we are definitely going to look to see whether other applications can be had in what cancers.
Yeah, James, safe travels and good luck with the trial and what's to come. And yeah, hopefully we'll talk shortly as the news unfolds. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, it's exciting times. Thanks, Jonathan.